Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And for those who are new here, I am Psychic Belle Love, and you can always book your own personal private reading on the website psychicbellelove.com. And for the month of May, we do have special discounted appointments for 15, 20, and 30 minute appointments starting at $35. So you can go to psychicbellelove.com and that will be listed under the services page. I will also have the link down below. Let's take a look at Shawn Mendes and Camila Cabello because they seem to be back on. I had predicted in their breakup video that at some point we would see them back together. So let's see what we are going to get from this going forward. Also, while I was shuffling the cards and grabbing the deck before I sat down to record this, I kept getting the feeling that we're gonna see her being pushed more in the direction of like the Spanish speaking audience, like coming out with Spanish language music and trying to kind of build her career more in that sector. So I do feel like we're gonna see her being very busy coming up. Lots of festivals, music dropping, maybe even some tours overseas, because I feel like it's almost like now Becky G started kind of with a little bit of an American audience and then she went more towards the Spanish audience. I feel like that's where they're sort of positioning Camila going forwards. So let's see about this reconciliation, because first it was like, oh, they made out at Coachella and then nothing happened for a minute. And now when I just went to go pull up pictures to use for the thumbnail, I was like, oh, they just literally had paparazzi catch them hanging out somewhere recently, I think like over the weekend. So let's see. Okay. You know, the thing is that Spirit's saying is this is very kind of like Mercury retrograde-ish, where it's like, I'm still attracted to you. However, there's a reason why this didn't work last time and we're gonna figure it out again. Like, you know, both of them want, I mean, this is the thing, both of them wanna get married and have kids in the future, but there's something that it's like, Shawn always feels like, as much as I can have love for Camila, I can't see you as my future wife, mother of my children. Like, there's always just this, like, we get to a certain point and then I can't see us progressing past that. And she shows up as the Page of Wands as far as how he sees her ultimately, as in, you still have a lot of growing to do. And there's the manipulative side to her that he doesn't like very much, that makes him nervous about building this future with her. She's very happy that they're going back to this situation again. However, again, it's like the problems from last time have not been resolved. There's still communication issues. There's still issues of not fully being on the same page. And as things in each of their careers moves forwards, that brings out bigger cracks in it. Because it's almost like Spirit saying, the reason why their relationship was even able to work as much as it did the last time around was because they were kind of shut down in the pandemic. You know, so it's like, you weren't leaving for work every day. I wasn't leaving for work every day. You weren't going to Argentina on a tour while I was going to Canada on my own. And now, like, when we both have to go back and step back into work mode, getting the bag mode, that's when we realize, again, it's like the action, the communication, what we need to make this relationship work ultimately falls apart all over again. And then it's just, There's something about the way that she communicates that makes him feel like she's manipulative and dishonest. And that always ends up becoming an issue as far as he is concerned. And there is, you know, the Three of Cups showing up here with this King of Swords, as in there is a very real possibility that she can end up cheating. So I don't feel like this reconciliation lasts for too long. I keep getting the number sevens. We've got 7 weeks or 7 months total before this kind of just falls apart again. It's just one of those things where it's like, we're 65% of what each other wants, not the 100%. And so because it's not the 100%, it always makes it almost damn near impossible for us to like, get too far within this relationship. So I think it's just, you know, there's still feelings and attraction there, but it's not enough to keep them together. Is there anything else you want to tell us, Spirit? And Spirit's saying they'll blame it on distance because of work issues. But there's something that she's not going to be honest with him about that's really going to make him pull the plug. That's surprising. I honestly, like, don't, you know a whole lot about Camilla other than just all the horrible things that she said about Normani and Black women in general, which makes me kind of be like, Sean, what are you doing? Because you seem like such a nice person. But I wasn't expecting that she's, you know, a super dishonest person when it comes to the relationship stuff. And sometimes it's just dumb things. Like, why did you tell me you had a bagel for lunch when you had a salad? Like, why would you lie about that? Like, it's little things like that that constantly happen that makes him feel like you are so untrustworthy that really just, you know, grinds his gears, so to speak, that makes him not want to keep pursuing more with her. Yeah, because it's just, they're both going to be so busy over the next couple years that it'll ultimately get blamed on, oh, you know, all the stuff that we both have going on separately made it too hard for this relationship to work out. But really, it's him realizing that he trapped himself and that she hasn't changed in the way that he was hoping. It's like, I was hoping that you grew up, that you had become a better version of yourself, but I'm not seeing that. Again, I can't go the distance with you, and you know, you've got your career to pursue. I have other things that are important to me, and they separate again. So enjoy the short-lived rebounds. They are not this generation's J-Lo and Ben Affleck, unfortunately. But they'll end up with better people that are more suited for the both of them. And honestly, I keep feeling like we're going to see Camilla with a Spanish language musician, not somebody like a Maluma, but somebody that's very well known in the Spanish music world that she goes, maybe she'll find the Spanish version of Shawn Mendes. Because I feel like it is very like singer-songwriter type vibes, you know, and then she makes all this music with the new guy. And that also helps things keep building as far as her career in the Spanish language side of the entertainment industry. And Sean will, you know, eventually end up kind of taking a humongous step back from the industry as I previously predicted. But that's where we are at with these two guys. So anyways, I am going to go ahead and wrap this one up. I got to go get my kiddo from school. I hope everybody is having a good one. If you are not already, make sure you have subscribed And make sure that you turn the notifications on so you don't miss anything. If you want to follow me on Instagram, join the Patreon, or book your own personal and private reading, all that information will be linked down below. And I will see y'all later. Bye, guys.